Thea for Rhino version 3 is introduced in the first part of this course, along with its user interface and workflow. We will start by examining the toolbar of the Thea Render user interface. Right-clicking or using the Thea Render menu both activate the Thea toolbar. The Thea toolbar offers shortcuts to other Thea panels, as well as icons for rendering in the viewport and icons for the Thea darkroom window. Both interactive and production rendering are done in the Thea darkroom. Additionally, it contains panels for display settings, render channels, and batch rendering. Finally, the Thea render settings panel can be accessed by right-clicking or via the Thea render menu. Rendering, environment, and camera options are divided into three tabs on this panel. It is important to note that in order to fully utilize Thea, we must select it as the current renderer from the render menu. This action will expose the new material type called Thea Material. As a last step, we will dock the Thea toolbar and the render settings panel. Let's have a look at how Thea Render is implemented in Rhino. Thea operates in two modes, interactive and production. Rhino's viewports and the Thea darkroom window both support interactive rendering. To begin rendering in the viewport, click the Thea toolbar's Start button. While rendering interactively, we can either capture the render image by clicking on the Save Image button, or stop rendering by clicking on the Stop button. By clicking on the camera icon, we will enter the Thea darkroom window. Before pressing the Start button, make sure the rendering mode option is set to IR, which stands for Interactive Rendering. The secondary window may be relocated to another monitor, freeing up the Rhino viewports. By default, Thea Darkroom renders the active viewport and changes as we go from one viewport to the other. After clicking on the lock icon, we may restrict the rendering to a certain viewport. We may change viewports in Rhino while Thea is locked to a certain view in this manner. The option to use the available denoisers in interactive mode is a fantastic addition to Thea Render. Tick Interactive Denoising in the Render Settings panel, Start Interactive Rendering, then activate the denoiser in the Display tab. In part 2, we will examine the display settings in more detail. Since the NVIDIA denoiser has a faster refresh rate, we shall use it in this case. Let's get started with production rendering. The difference between this mode and interactive mode is that once the rendering begins, it will not be updated with any changes to the scene. To render in production mode, open the Thea Darkroom window and activate the production toggle button. One change we observe is that a few of parameters, notably the termination criteria, have become available. These two values are used to notify Thea when to stop rendering. Samples and time limit are the two options. We may specify whether we want the rendering process to stop after a certain number of samples or for an indefinite period of time. A value of 0 denotes the infinite. If we set limitations for both values, the rendering will stop when the first limit is met. Let us set the sample limits to 32 samples per pixel. Before we begin rendering, we will go to the render settings and set the final resolution from the camera tab. Let's have a look at the remaining toolbar icons. The first two icons are only available when in interactive mode. When depth of field is enabled, the first icon, Pick Camera Focus, selects the focal point of the active camera. The autofocus option must be unchecked for this to work. Depth of field will be discussed in length in the following videos. The next icon, Pick Material, is used to select materials from the displayed rendered view, rather than doing it manually. Click on the icon, then on a part of the image, while in interactive mode. The selected material will be displayed in the Material Editor window. Render Region is the third icon. You may use this tool to define an area that Thea will utilize instead of the entire image and focus all of the processing power on. Render Region also works in production mode and is enabled when an image has already been rendered. To use it, draw an area, increase the samples or time limit, and begin rendering. There is one more item worth mentioning: resume rendering in production mode. Assume we have a rendered image and need to add more samples to it. This is when resume rendering might come in handy. First, set the samples or time limit to a greater value than the previous one, then hold down Ctrl and press the Start button. Thea will resume rendering where it left off. Please go to the next part where we will be creating an exterior scene while learning about materials, asset management, environment, and other topics. Thank you for watching.